groove, eleganza.
Kill them with the groove, style and pattern. Bad girl, Yannick, you're from Jamaica. African boy, you.
Welcome back to the Sports Mag Zone. Guess what, guess what, guess what, guess what? Celebrity Knock is back. Celebrity Knock, of course, is where we invite influential and or prominent persons to talk about their lives and their careers. It doesn't have to have anything to do with sport, you know. In previous episodes, we've given you recording artists, we've given you music producers, we've had athletes, we've even had politicians. To start this new season, we're going to speak with someone who has been on the entertainment scene since 2006. She has many hats from what I hear, literally, and sometimes she wears the one labeled artiste. Other days she puts on the one that's called entrepreneur, TV host, radio host, and she has a new one, restaurateur. Yeah, she's the boss of many things and she works with the title Lifestyle Boss. You saw her image earlier, so I'm not telling you any secrets when I say the Curvy Diva, Yannick Barthe, is here inside the studio with us. Yannick, welcome to Sports Mag. Good to have you.
Thanks for having me.
Excellent. Mariah, it's International Women's Day was this week.
Yes, it was.
We're still in that period, so I'm asking Mariah to open the innings. It's only fair.
Yannick, every day is International Women's Day, right? These people need to recognize that. So I'm going to start by, one, telling you that I love Lifestyle. When I went to Trinidad for Christmas, I had to introduce this song to all my girls. Like, I was playing it and I'm like, it's so empowering. So what pushes you and, you know, what keeps you motivated to continue empowering other women through your music?
Just love, the love for it. And I think that continues to push me even more because I just love what I do. And there's, you know, I'm passionate about it and I enjoy doing what I do. So that's what keeps me going.
If you had to say what your greatest moment was performing, of course, I could tell that you miss being, on a live stage. Which moment would that be?
Oh my goodness, I think it would be Reggae Sunfest. I always talk about this. Reggae Sunfest for me, performing on Reggae Sunfest was amazing for me. Because every time it was always, you know, hosting, or if it's not that, interviewing other artists. So when I turn artist now and step out, and then I walk out on stage and I'm not hosting, I'm not there calling on anybody, but I was called on. I was like, oh my God. I walk out there with a different attitude, like, Reggae! You know, walk on, and I was just enjoying myself, and the performance for me was just amazing because tears came to my eyes, and just, you know, even interviewing afterwards, I was like, oh my God, I've done something that I wanted to do, I was passionate about, really and truly dreamt about it, and I was like, all this time I was always living vicariously through other artists that I was interviewing, so finally it was my chance, and I was like, yes. Madea, Reggae Sunfest. So, you know, I mean, I've hit bigger stages and different stage after that. You know, Africa was huge for me, but Reggae Sunfest was the start, and that's always memorable for me.
Yannick, I want to ask you this question early. The interview has much further to go, but I want to ask you this early. People who are successful, women who are successful, they attract a kind of hate from a section of the audience that is unbelievable, and I can't see why. People who are attractive, people who are beautiful, people who are successful, people who are out there, people who have big personalities, and you tick all of those boxes. How do you reconcile some of the things that you wake up and read on your social media feed or that people send to you that, Yannick, look what somebody's saying about you over there. When you read it, you realize, but this person doesn't even know me and I don't know who the person is they're talking about. How do you reconcile that?
I swear. I mean, before I started reading a really, really good book, it's like a daily digest thing and something. Yeah. Before that, you know, I'd be like the typical person, say, oh, them bad men, oh, them dirty people, me hate them, or, you know, me kind of say them lucky, them don't know me. No, it's kind of, the feeling is more of, I kind of just feel sorry for them. And I understand where a lot of times persons will come and they'll be like, oh, we hate on somebody and, you know, the girl didn't look good or she whatever. But honestly, it's reflecting how they are, how they feel about themselves. And I even find myself, if I look on a situation or a person or anything and I'm like, I said, check myself, never say, hold on there. Is it that me really and truly feel that this person is that, like, I'm a bad mind the person? Yes. Hold on, Yannick, I'm a bad mind, me just bad mind, smarty. So, you know, really and truly, it's just them hating their own situation that they're in, and they decide that, you know, let me put down somebody else to feel better about themselves. And it's not gonna make them situation better anyways.
You know a lot about investments, I'm sure. You know that your good investment manager will sit with you and say, well, Yannick, you have to have a diversified portfolio. I say that because in the tough times that we've experienced, today's the one-year anniversary nature of the WHO declaring COVID a pandemic.
Yeah. Yeah.
So a lot of things have dried up. Income streams have dried up. If you didn't have a diversified range of activities, some people would starve or worse. Talk to me about how you've been able to manage this difficult period with a number of things that you leveraged your talent in over time.
Oh God, listen, COVID brought out the hustle in everybody. If it not really bring out the hustle in you, that means you're just not a hustler. Just go and work with the hustle of them out there. But I mean, when I saw it and I realized that the last show for me was, I think it was last year in March,
yes.
or about yeah. March, April. And I was like, hold on, every other show had to be canceled. My agent calling me, boy, I don't want to cancel, you know, they're pushing it for summer. Summer, they're like, we're not ready, not happening. And I was like, you know what? I had enough funds saved up and, you know, me take me time and budget. But then I said to myself, you know what? I had, you know, signed a contract, I'd had some endorsement thing. And I said, boy, I have that funds. What am I going to do with this? Continue, you know, going down. Or really and truly follow my passion, follow my heart. And I said, I did the pop-up kitchen. And, you know, before opening the restaurant, I didn't want to just dive into it. I did the pop-up kitchen twice, and then the third time, I said, boy, this is too much. Whole heap of people want it. The demand is so much.
Yes.
And I said, all right, well, let me, you know, borrow somebody's kitchen. I said, beg your kitchen, no?
Yes.
You understand? Before me even get one from me, I said, beg your kitchen, man. Milk borrows.
Yeah.
And I said, all right, you know, we're not close with kitchen, so we cook. And I said, me cook side of you, man. Go on, man. And I did that. And when I realized, hey, a whole heap of people love it, a whole heap of people ordered, I said, okay, now is the time to really do it. So it was very hard, and I know it must be hard. And even now, because before I opened the grand opening, which was February 14th, on the 10th of February, the Prime Minister was like, listen, we're going to change it to 8 o'clock.
Yes.
And I was like, sir, me not open yet. 10. You didn't say 10, me not open 10.
You're budgeting for 10.
I'm budgeting for 10 p.m. And it was 8. And then now he's like, well, the bars are going to be closed 6 o'clock. I said, Mr. Olness, why? So, you know, it's just a meeting right now since I opened. But I'm just grateful, same way. Persons love the food, and that's the main thing.
So restaurateur is ticked. That's something that many people didn't see in you, I'm sure, and you're gonna make it a success. I want to talk about your music, because guess what? We all knew and many of us loved you as a radio host, a TV host, and the way you projected yourself in your work. But artist Yannick, some of us couldn't reconcile that. When I got the YouTube link for that smash single Lifestyle, I said, all right, what am I going to get with this? Is it that where, you know, the typical thing where the celebrity has a professional artist helping them and it not going so good? But as Mariah said, that song was a smash hit. And if people, Yannick, doubted your quality, you'd say to them, okay, you think I'm just for show? Go to YouTube, type in Bongs Funnit with DeMarco, and look at my 43 million views. Yeah?
Exactly.
Tell me about the music. How did you successfully transition from TV personality into an artist that people have to take seriously?
Listen, I've always loved music. I've always been passionate about music. And I think that's just my thing. So I have a thing about me. I have certain things that I want to accomplish, certain goals that I set. I might not advertise it. I might not be, you know, bragging to my friends, but I quietly music part of it, the whole industry,
yes.
And how hard it is for females and all of that back and forth. And I said to myself, if I'm not ready and if I'm not stable enough to really take on that, I didn't want to go into it. So after a while, I build the name Curvy Diva. The brand is going. The respect is there. You know, me walk in, people can say, oh, that's Curvy Diva,
yes.
Whichever part. And I said, yeah, man, now is the time I feel comfortable enough to step out and,
right.
You know, become an artist. And it worked for me, and the talent is there, evidence is there.
Definitely.
As I say, I don't have time to prove to anybody. Say, oh, you know, me an artist.
Yes.
Nobody know.
Yes.
Me can't need you. Me can't. Nah, I let it speak for itself.
Yanni, you are a roots woman at the base level, and you can go high with the men and women in suits and business attire, and you can fit in. Let me ask you this though. Pumpkin dies on the vine. It is easy to achieve, perhaps it is easier to achieve fame and be in the limelight and then slowly watch yourself fall into irrelevance. Mm. But since 2006, from then to now, Mariah, you are the math whiz from Naps, what, 15 years?
Mm.
15 years, you've never been away from the limelight. You've always maintained a presence.
Mm.
How have you managed to remain relevant over a decade and a half?
Yeah.
Ah, listen, it's all about the right team. And I think that is very important. And persons need to understand, once you have the right team, you have persons who have the same vision you have, or even more, or better, or bigger. And you really and truly depend on that, and depend on your dream and your goal, and you meet up with the right people. Street cred always bless them up. Janice always finding different ways. So I said, all right then, I want to open a restaurant. And she's like, yeah, man. And I said, I want to do a cookbook. She's like, yeah, man, let's do it this way. Let's reach these people. Let's do this. Mm-hmm. And then she's like, all right then, let's do that. Matter of fact, let's go to Atlanta. Atlanta have that station. I know you can actually cook and pay-per-view, and persons can pay to see you cook, and we can do a pop-up kitchen there. Having the right team around you. And Shensia can speak for that. I know Romish is excellent at that. Yeah. So having the right set of people to really guide you and guide your career. A lot of time, the artist is very talented, but also the wrong set of people and not the right opportunity. Yeah. And Yannick, let us fall out.
I just have one question before we go. When am I getting more music?
Oh, jeez, I just put out music, you know.
I know
you guys need more music, but the thing is, the world is opening up finally. The vaccine is coming and all of these things happening. So right as, you know, now it's the time to really put out some more music. I've been, you know, giving it a little break. Yes. I have my new single, Oh No, Eleganza, which is a remix with Solid Star from Africa, and Africa love me. You know, Africa is huge.
Yes.
You know, so I'm just waiting for them to open the world. Once it open, no tour is going to happen, all of these things. So more music will be pushing out then.
All right. So if you thought that she was talking about the kitchen as an abstract thing, mm-hmm. I'm going to sample her creation. What's on this box? It says pigtail, does it?
Oh, geez, on the barbecue.
No, barbecue pigtail.
All right. We got to talk with
aptitude. So the thing though, Yannick, is that there's something wrong with Mariah's throat. So I'm going to have to be the solo tester.
I don't think that's wrong with
my camera guy says I should tilt the box.
Maybe he's telling the viewers that, Yannick, because he heard it right. Taste good. Yannick, mm-hmm. I have a feeling he heard it taste good and he just wants to eat all.
Hello, may I try and be able to the mountain here? There you go, all right?
Look at it.
So that's the barbecue pigtail.
Glossy and nice. Geez, I'm friend. No man, I look nice.
All right, so I'm going to sample. How am I going to sample and speak?
I can speak. So George,
okay, I really can speak for you. This is so good. I'm loving this.
Getting back to my bone, let me put that right here.
And the bone is
dish.
Tender.
There's another dish. Yes, it falls off the bone. And it does.
Falls off the bone. Yeah, another dish. For you.
There's another dish.
Yannick, maybe you can tell them, you know, if they want to find the page that you have the food. I know you have a food page. Yes, they can go across and check it out.
Yeah, man. Dining
please,
with
go
Kirby.
Ahead and talk about that too.
Let me tell them. Dining with Kirby. It's on Instagram. You definitely can find it. And of course, the number is 876-281-7411. You can call, WhatsApp, all of that. We are in Jamaica and we're going to take the world eventually. So just wait for it. Oh, delicious.
It looks really good. It really
that does.
That
is baked chicken with a nice cream sauce.
Hold on, Randy, so hold on.
All right.
This is
good. Yeah. You want to deliver it?
Yeah, I'm going to have to go to a break because I'm going to finish this.
Mm-hmm.
Any, thank you very much. Thank you for good music. Thank you for being fabulous. Thank you for good food.
And keep on empowering other women.
I wish you every success. There's no bad mind in here. We love when people strive. I can't understand why people wake up and hate others.
Hate
it makes no sense. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much, girl. All the best.